Hello everyone and welcome back for another episode of Monday Night Gaming. As you can see, we made it to level 15 on our last session, and we're going to be pushing on and seeing if we can make it all the way to level 20. We've just finished off after having helped the old man blacksmith kill his young apprentice. Yeah, well, not quite. We had to get the Malium Menhir hammer for one of the blacksmiths, and we got to choose which one we went with. We went with the traditional blacksmith rather than the newfangled enchanty one. This is really good for us. It unlocks the crafting system, so that's something that we might look at during this session and in the future. While I was off camera, I've had a little bit of reading up on different mechanics within Grimdawn, and it seems if you're a high enough level over certain mobs, you won't get any experience for them. So I might go just off camera hunting for extra scrap and items that do get used in crafting, just to keep the pace high as we play. But for now, we're going to jump into a game with Matrix and carry on with the plot line. So give me just a couple of moments and I'll be right back.
Okay, so where were we?
We were searching for the caravan driver. Well, we just got to Burwich, really. So let's head back to Burwich. And who knows, maybe we'll encounter that caravan driver or the remains of them.
Okay.
But yeah, really, we're supposed to be securing Burwich Village itself.
There was also that... who are these guys?
These are the people we didn't help.
Blacksmith that we didn't kill.
Although, who's Darien? I can't do this. I can't. This is all too much. Just hang in there, Darien.
Didn't we find him and you told him to go find these guys?
Maybe.
Pretty sure that was a thing that happened.
He's safe anyway. That's the important thing. We just did the blacksmith collection. So we haven't explored up this way at all.
Oh yes, and we kind of wanted to go back and hunt extra cult people looking for the key for that locked door.
Ooh, that's a very good point. I might do that off camera at some point, rather than just spending hours...
We could always head right over to the locked door now.
Oh, and kill the cultists there, that's a good plan.
Yeah, because they're like right outside the door, and it's just the other side of the road from here at the moment.
Alright, well... We'll just kill these couple of spiders. He says, just a couple of spiders, and then everything else starts coming towards. I'll let you kill them with your massive ranged... A weathered mallet just dropped on the ground, and I misread it as weathered mullet.
It's all well and good you saying kill them at range, but don't forget they've got those like healing dudes amongst them. There's a big old champion guy here. No, sorry, he's not big old champion, he was just called a champion.
He was just called a champion.
Yep.
No actual special thing about him.
No, he was just big.
No, my name is Lawyer. I'm not a lawyer.
Yeah.
Alright, well let's start fighting our way back over there.
Okay.
Goblin Snake Clan scavengers.
I'm a little tempted to decrease the AoE on this, just a smidge.
Why?
Just so I can start putting points into other stuff.
Oh right, you mean just move things around a bit?
Yeah, pretty much.
Okay. Well, I guess that kind of makes sense. Now... Oh, that's a lot of...
Lost the whole camp.
Yep.
Level 15, lovely. This guy is a champion.
You okay?
Let's say yes. My little electric raven's got him covered.
Saved you.
Supercharged improvised rounded shield of the fox.
That sounds pretty cool if any of us use shields. I don't think I got anything nice from it. Oh, I got some scrap. Yay! Blueprint, guardsman's breastplate. Okay, I got something nice out of it.
Nice. What's the blueprint like?
I will link it to you in just a second. I'm just looting the room thoroughly. Okay.
The room.
So to link stuff, I just shift click on it, don't I? Like that.
Yes. Part of a set.
Yeah. epic heavy chest armor, 182 armor. That's huge.
Yep.
Required level 22. That's going to be a while.
Yeah.
But even so, I'm still happy getting more ingredients, blueprints. That one. Have you actually reduced your... oh no, you need to go back to town for that, don't you?
No, I don't. Well, yes, I do, actually. Yeah, you're quite correct. I haven't. Well, I'm not sure if I will now that it's taking a couple of hits to kill things.
Now, it was actually this way.
Oh, actually, I haven't actually put my skills from this level.
Right, oh, that's a very good point. Neither have I, so let's do that now. So this was 222, this one there, and then Nightblade. We're going to go...
Start pushing up this way, yeah.
Now, this is nearly up to the maximum Belgothian shears. So next level will be the last point we put into it, and then we're just going to be powering along here, probably until we get to Hidden Hand.
Found the cult.
Okay, I'll be right there.
There won't be any left by the time you get here.
Well, don't blow up the key.
I missed, but rather than my bullet carrying on and hitting the guy behind, it just disappeared into nothingness. I call hacks.
Well... what can I say? It's a quality game.
Oh, you know, I was saying, hey, you guys, I love your hats.
Yeah.
And then I kind of wish that
you had
Transmog was in this game.
Yeah.
Well, someone has modded in Transmog.
Oh, well, that's kind of cool.
After our first playthrough, once we've had a chance to come out of beta mod status, I might insist that we put it on so that I can play fantasy dress up properly.
It's important that when you're doing like Demon Hunter Barbie, you've got the proper options available. Lightbringers, Woven Cord, Rare Belt, not that brilliant, but you know, it's green. It'll be worth three more bits than everything else.
Oh yeah, that's the other thing I was going to do. I was going to turn off my common loot. There we go.
I'm going to do it after we head back to town the next time, because I've picked up all whites so far.
Yeah, so have I. I'm heading back to town now.
I'm just having one last look around here, make sure we've got everyone killed. Yeah.
Unlike some other games, picking up garbage is actually a waste of time in this one.
Well, it's not... yeah, it is. If you think about time efficiency for getting iron bits...
to realise.
Now,
heading back to town...
I read something about deconstructing items. Do you know anything about that?
Yes, I do. It's not really spoilers, so I suppose I can tell you. Later, we get the Inventor's Apprentice, and the Inventor's Apprentice can deconstruct items.
So at that point, is it worth picking up white items?
No, because there's nothing really to deconstruct from white items.
Okay. Important questions. Like, should I be storing all of these for later?
I would say no.
Okay, let's sell that. I'll sell that, and yeah, we will sell that. Right, so I need to go to the blacksmith to teach him this.
No, you don't. You just right-click it in your inventory.
Oh, right.
You could have done that a long time ago.
Yeah. Not a problem. And we'll just order this better. All right, I'm ready to head back.
See, I'd need to sacrifice 5 points out of this in order to get up to here. Do I want to do that? Not yet.
Auto show loot is on magic only now.
Yeah, I think that's probably fine actually at the moment.
It's a shame that obviously you'll lose the visibility on some items, but holding alt makes them all visible. But don't they fade out over time anyway, so then you end up holding alt and then you'll see everything?
Don't know. I don't think I've ever left an item on the ground long enough for it to fade out.
I have moved on ever so slightly, so come back through my portal.
Your portal is actually way behind me, so no thanks.
What?
Oh, your new portal, right. because I had already passed your portal.
Right, I didn't realise you were already back. I thought you were still in town. There be scavengers over here.
Yeah, rat folk. Briarthorn horrors. I found shaman pets.
Okay.
Shaman get these as pets.
What?
You didn't know.
Cool. I didn't actually know that there was pets in this, really.
Of course there is. You've seen the devotions, plus the pet damage. Seen my raven.
Oh, right, yeah. Sorry, not vanity pets, but real pets.
Vanity pets. Well, my raven is pretty spiffy.
And you're pretty vain.
Doing alright against those mosquitoes.
Yeah. I was just picking the ones that you'd left behind. So this is where we found what's-his-face with Angry. The Malian men here.
Did he tell us it was called the Malian men here?
I hope the Inventor's Apprentice is as much of a colourful character. Yeah, definitely not picking up nearly as much stuff.
Yeah, I hadn't even crossed my mind that we hadn't been.
I think I picked up one thing. But the world feels empty now. That's the only downside.
I'm not sure I'd call it a damn Grobble Sky Clan.
Alright, let's back up a bit.
Yeah, especially because there's a heroic in here. You might be able to tell from the fire going on everywhere.
Alright.
Alright, now we've got them cornered. Unfortunately, he's flame touch, so yeah. I'm not great against him.
I've got him. I am going to stand slightly out of the fire just for a moment here.
I am cursing periodically.
Got him! Don't run in the fire.
Ooh, another gunslinger's jacket. What am I going to do with two of these?
I only got scrap from that. And frost shroud ointment. Oh, I should have used my flame drinker ointment. 30% fire resistance.
Yeah, that would have been smart. Yeah, just run away from combat. Excuse me a moment, I've got to go get a drink first. A bit parched.
Oh. That was a fun little excursion. Let's head on down.
Come over here.
Or not.
Right, now press Alt and then let it go.
What, I can see the yellow bits and then they vanish.
Oh no, I was thinking the items that we haven't picked up. It just shows that they don't take forever to fade out. They just vanish immediately again.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, the ult doesn't cause a fading thing, it's just an instant show or hide. Let's head back south and then we'll head across to the west.
I left some iron bits up there just because I couldn't be bothered to get back.
Oh, this pocket change. Can't be dealing with any of that.
Yeah, trouble is I already regret it. Everything's so expensive in this game.
Morning Star.
Food ration.
And iron bits. Delicious and
delicious iron
crunchy,
bits.
Crunchy.
Full of iron, don't you know?
Yeah. Ooh, cave entrance. Shall we just hobble straight in?
Yeah, sure.
He says, having already clicked on the entrance. Burial cave. This doesn't sound ominous. Oh. It's like an overseer up there. And a reanimator! Oh!
I remember the reanimator!
Quite a good, watchable old B-movie.
And then there was Bride of Reanimator and Reanimator 3, whatever that was called.
Hopefully not Reanimator. Reanimator Revolutions. There's a shrine.
The Reanimatrix. I found a shrine.
I know you said that already, but... Killing more things. Well done, pat, pat, pat.
Fix the shrine.
Good for you.
Well, kind of is. Put a point in my devotion. That's the one.
your divsions.
Yeah. Man, what sort of idiot makes fireproof zombies?
That's the kind of thing I would do. Ah. The Reanimator 4. Fireproof. Oh, no. Flame retardant.
Well, you're flame retardant.
Oh. When jokes come to you just a bit too slow.
Well, you are flame retardant.
Alright, let's I'm gonna put my devotion point in. So, I was working through the Wolverine. Plus 35% to all retaliation damage, or plus 3% defensive ability, and reduced requirements for melee weapons. They're both good, but I'm gonna go with retaliation damage because I'm not in need of reduced requirements at the moment. Did you head back?
Not through town, no. I just came out the exit again. Found some guys on fire.
That must be my...
Also some guys on frost, apparently.
Alright, hang on, I'll stick my face out. Just trying to decide whether
guys
to go back to...
Guys on fire might have been on fire because I set them on fire.
Fair enough. So this is... Oh, this is just up a little way. Alright, that's fair enough. Let's clear this area out to the east. Clear!
Big old fire, my favourite element.
Ooh, there's a fury here.
Oh yeah, that's the guy I set on fire.
Oh, there's a big boss overseer thing.
Oh yeah, Illumin, the electrified.
Right, I'm going to kill the...
I'll kill everything else.
Yeah, I'm going for him.
I've got to change my angle to get a good shot at him, because he's hovering above a thing. There we go.
Got him!
Mystic Gaze Eye of the Void.
I got three yellows from it.
So the Gazer Eye...
Oh, that's one of the wrist drops, isn't it?
Nah, not quite. This is... the things I mentioned before are more rare. These are kind of like monster frequents, I suppose, if you can call the other thing a monster infrequent.
Right, okay.
There you go. Cold one. So these drop relatively frequently from this sort of bad guy.
Yeah.
Ghost beholder type things.
That makes sense.
But yes, comes with innate plus to stun jacks, this one.
And do all of them come with that?
No, they don't all come with stun jacks. That would be weird.
I mean, all the eyes.
Oh yeah, all eye types do. But like, we can get Fleshwalk Mutant Arm, which has got plus to something else.
Oh, cool. Witch Doctor down.
Ooh. Flame Eater.
I'm on him. He's sort of trying to back off a bit.
Yeah, I don't blame him. I'd run away from me.
Not...
Scrap metal heavy crossbow of veracity.
Are these blue items that you're... Sorry, green items that you're...
Green. Yeah. The gunslinger's jacket that I got was, oh, actually, this scrap metal heavy crossbow is better than that blue arbalest that I got before.
Well, that's very interesting. Ooh, wait, I'm level 16. I'm heading back to town. Because I've got something in my stash that I could be using, that I should be using.
And then if I put this searing ember on it as well, that's going to be awesome. Doink.
This is totally how adventuring goes.
Well, I'm going to use your portal. Why not? Since you've gone back to town, I may as well.
Yeah, and let's just sell up the rest of the stuff I've got, I think.
It's a shame that that blue item only lasted, like, one level.
Yeah.
Well, actually, I suppose it was two levels, really. I'm going to save it so that I can deconstruct it later, just to see what they do.
Okay. Right, so... Demolition is... Oh, I should have actually offered you this.
You still can?
Yeah. I was just getting it back so I could...
Magic offhand? No. Also, searing light, what's that?
You're a demolitionist, baby. You.
So are you.
Yeah, very good point.
Oh gosh, it's the...
Flashbang. Flashbang expansion. Brilliant.
Yep. Extra DLC content right there. Oh man, this is really good actually. Because of course I spec'd into a cultist.
Yeah.
This heavy crossbow does vitality damage, and I've already got plus the vitality damage in my Soleil's Witchfire. Does plus 64% vitality damage actually.
Oh, that's very cool. There's some weapons that are appearing that are now slightly better than the offhand, like regular weapon that I'm using. But I'm not tempted by them because they cost half of my entire money. Alright, let me just pop back up here and I will check, see what level the other item I have is.
Safe storage, no questions asked.
Level 17. So I'm actually going to bring that with me so I can just switch to it straight in the field, because we're really close to level 17 at the moment anyway. And in fact, saying that, I could put something on it ahead of time. So let's do that. Right, we're going to get all of these components. And we're doing this because we're going to go to the blacksmith and see if we can craft something cool.
Do you mean like chilled steel cool? Or?
Yeah, well, exactly that kind of thing, like a component or some kind of upgrade. What's a wrath stone? Extra ether damage. And this is an ether damage weapon, I think, ish. Mm.
While you're doing that, I'm pretty close to the next level. I need like 832 XP, so I'm just going to head back and find something to punch. Punch with a bullet.
Of course.
Really, it's a crossbow bolt, I suppose, so punch with a bolt. We sort of cleared out that area. Right, it's going to be a while.
So some of these are just, you know, switching between different types. So it's... That's interesting.
But you see, the advantage between switching between different types is that your skills will multiply certain types, but not others.
Now, what does this go on? All weapons and shit. Yeah, so... Might be alright. Let's see if we can find something that's just going to make it better, though. That's just solid extra damage. Apologies, I know this is a highly entertaining watching that's going on at the moment.
Oh, found a place called Mud Row.
I was just about to go into there before we came back, I think. Alright, so that's physical to fire, plus to fire, and generally I'm quite fire-y, so yeah, why not? Let's get one of those. So I have some enchanted flint that is going. Can I not use it yet? Oh, required level 20. Fine. Well,
the flint can't be used, or
yeah,
that is kind of funny. You can use my portal if you want to catch up with me, by the way.
Alright. I'm just going to put all my junk back in the thing and then I'll be right there.
Got something you need stashed? Keep an eye.
Including that flint. God damn it. Yeah, I'm really close to the next level as well, so I won't be long. I am just about to step through the portal, if you could re-put it next to you.
Yep, have done.
And... ooh, a food ration.
I thought you might be hungry after your teleportation.
Yeah. Well, if there's anything I learned from Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, it's that you need to have some protein after matter transportation. Yeah. Congratulations.
Well, it means that blue sword can now go in my weapon switch because I never melee. So,
yes.
It's like a good place to put it.
Yeah, it's good storage.
Plus 400 damage per second on the old one that I had in there.
Wow.
Actually, you can't use it for some reason. Oh, required physique 205. Well,
time to put some points in physique.
Thing. Nah, that was a bad thing to have been carrying around for like a level and a half, two levels, four levels, whatever.
Yeah. Was it actually in your inventory for that entire time?
Yes.
That's totally not embarrassing, you know.
I'm not embarrassed by it. I'm just kind of pointless.
So I just popped down here because there were some item bits.
What, white?
Yellow.
This looks like it might be the caravan owner.
Burwich Bridge Repair Site.
Is this the other side of that?
I guess it might be. Take one dynamite to clear the... Right, so...
No, this is a different thing.
That's not going to happen. Hmm.
All of these waterfront properties, they really didn't think about...
the zombie apocalypse. No, they didn't. Don't build on a volcano. Don't build on a floodplain. Don't build on... contaminated towards the ground.
Yeah, don't build anywhere that mad scientists are trying to bring people back to life. It's just common sense, really.
Oh, this? No, it's a decorative zombie. I just leveled up, so we're going to swap over for that. And I'm going to assign my skills in just a moment after I kill...
Found Burwich Village, it's across those bridges.
Cool,
alright. I'm sure we could... go a different way though.
So we're,
like, we're still looking for that caravan driver.
Yeah, we are. So I think if we head back where we came from.
Hey, found a flesh warp thing.
Cool.
Also, some arsehole is shooting at me from up there. If you wouldn't mind stabbing them.
Got him. In the building. There is not much.
No, not even anything to shoot.
Yeah, we can head across to the west. There's chests and stuff out back, though. So I'm bannering over there.
Warped iron six gun of the Rift Hound.
That sounds pretty cool.
Shoots dogs, but slightly wonkily.
Okay, I now feel like I'm doing a very decent amount of damage.
Good.
Hey, Ulgrim. Hey, Ulgrim.
A living person.
Well, I'll be a living person. I've been stranded out here since Burwich fell. Fortified myself on this little patch of island, cooking whatever critters got too close while waiting for the inevitable end. You're a welcome sight for sore eyes. Burwich fell months ago. How have you survived this long? Well, I can cook for one. I used to work in the capital and had the honor of preparing meals for a couple of noble houses and many foreign dignitaries. I'm not a fighter, but I learned to hunt a bit when necessary. It gets me by. Scraps of the bone rash aren't exactly fine dining, though. Most of all, I just keep quiet and observe. What about you? Where do you hail from? Two options. We could use a cook, or... Sorry, I have no idea who you are. I don't trust him. He actually looks shiftier than... Well,
nah, tell him we could use a cook. I'm getting tired of eating your pre-eaten food.
Sorry, I have no idea who you are. Playing it close to the vest, eh? I can respect that, given the times. I assure you, I'm just an old cook doing his best to survive out here. Frankly, probably won't be doing much more surviving given the way things are getting out there. Alright. We could use a cook. This prison of yours sounds like heaven compared with my current dwelling. I bet I could do my share as well. Men fight better on full stomachs. How will we get on my equipment to Devil's Crossing? I can open a rift gate to safety.
Also, what equipment? I see nothing. His tent is empty.
The fire itself, I'm assuming. A portal? I've only ever seen one of those before, and it wasn't spinning out the good guys. I really hope you're not trying to pull one on me. Here goes nothing. I'll see you in Devil's Crossing.
Wow, he is as trusting as you are.
Yeah, this is the only way to survive out here.
Let's go into this tiny little island to the south first.
Okay.
It's a little isolated. By south, I mean now east from... It was south where we were.
Absolutely fine. Directional senses. That's interesting. It's raining.
Guess there's a big guy in there.
Yeah. Stormseeker. I'm on him. I'm backing off. Woohoo!
Got him.
It was actually...
Sacrificial.
Ooh, Blight Shard Amulet. That's an epic amulet. Level 24. I could have probably quaffed a potion to...
An altar.
Roiling blood. Yeah, not really much, but, you know, freebies. And that's back where we were in Mudbrow. Yeah, have a look at this.
Well, that's nice. It's a granted skill. Summon Blighted Rift Scourge. That's a pet.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah, I could have a Rift Scourge doggy following me around.
It's probably not any use to you, but...
I don't know if that's... I can't actually tell how it compares, but no, it's level 10, so it won't be better than my current stuff. Mouldering Fields.
Still doesn't sound like the Burwich Road.
No. There's actually a road here.
Ah. Oh, yes. Stop using guns on me! I use guns on you, not the other way around.
In Soviet Russia, bad guys shoot you. No, wait.
This doesn't look ominous.
No.
Is it just one mouldering field?
I guess it is.
Alright, I'm going to go back to town.
I will come with. Okay. Devil's Crossing. Mostly so I can put that amulet down, because I'm not going to get to use it for another 5 levels.
Yeah, so I can speak to the chef guy.
Well, if it isn't my savior, I cannot thank you enough. I finally get to cook for other people again. Here, have some soup. Could use some salt, but Captain Whiskey over there insists it's for combat use only.
Does he actually say Captain...
Captain Whiskey does. Glad you settled in. It's
safe with Come me. Back anytime. I've got a few old stories to tell if you have an ear to listen.
So I've spoken to him before in single player. He has lots and lots of stories. I'm not going to go through them. Also, he does soup once per game session. So only have soup when you actually need to fill your constitution back up.
Oh, right. So it's like a food ration.
Yeah, like a single-use food ration.
Well, that's kind of cool.
It might come back after a few hours, but I've never stuck around long enough to find out.
Fair enough. See anything you like. Alright, let's sell all of this stuff.
Let's get rid of the junk and see if there's anything... good that I picked up to replace it with. Not so far.
I'll buy that one bit of scrap that was in there.
Damn it. Iron well spent. For ages I was going and doing that and just like being really sly about it because you didn't know what scrap was for. Now you know, it's all ruined.
Well, I'm probably going to grind for it off camera as I said, so it's not going to be that big a deal. Plus, it cost 800, so I don't think I'm gonna buy any more of it because it's so expensive. Everything's expensive.
Alright, where was I? Mouldering Fields.
Just a little bit to the north.
I see.
I found raptors.
Carrion raptors, no less. Raptors that apparently have sonic screams.
It's important when you're creating these raptors that you imbue them with at least one element. Sonic is an element.
Have you seen the shaman pets yet? It's these things.
No, I haven't. So if you play a shaman, then you can get one of them.
Yep, they're well cool. They basically do tons of damage and tank forever. So
yeah, that's the definition of cool. Got the food ration out back.
I noticed these guys are now, some of them are level 14 and only blue on the number.
Yeah.
Getting close to just not being worth anything.
That's okay though, I think we're making good progress despite...
Hey! Jawnax the Voracious Swift.
Oh, hang on. Hold on, where is... Slam! Haha! Because I've actually got an ability on my thing, I can now slam for 200% damage in one single move. Slam is very awesome. Also, I just found...
Formidable embroidered hat. That's alright.
You want it?
Can I hold it for a moment? Sorry, is this easier to see?
Yeah, to compare.
Because it actually gives you the side-by-side thing. No, it's worse than mine.
I only offered it because it looks the part.
Yeah, it's only just a little bit worse than mine, but it's still worse.
Oh, Alistair's diary.
Cool. Do you want to read it?
Yeah, that's... First entry.
Oh.
Mama told me to write in this thing, so I suppose now's as good as ever, seeing as I'm grounded. Again! So I pulled Abigail's hair. She started...
No. Your voice is that of an old crotchety man.
No.
This is obviously the diary of a small boy. Please, train your voice, change it. Not start again, just carry on, just with a correct voice.
So I pulled Abigail's hair. She started
it.
That's
your normal voice. This is now you. Why again?
Why doesn't she have to sit in her room and write in her stupid diary? Tomorrow I'll catch the biggest frog I can find in the marshes and leave it in sister's room. We'll see how she likes that.
Now you sound like a drunk teenager.
He was supposed to have the emotion coming through, like tearing up because of how unfair it was. So Mum has been reading my diary and now I'm grounded again. The frog got out before sister even saw it. Why isn't Papa home yet? He was supposed to take me out to Burwich today and he's still not back from business. Third entry. Mama says I'm not allowed to play outside anymore. Perkins said that there are monsters roaming the marshes, but Mama said there's no such thing and she whooped me with a ladle for talking rumours again. I wish Papa would come home already. I want to go to Burwich. Fourth entry. I'm scared. I'm really, really scared. Mama locked me and sister in my room while she checked out some noises behind the house. It's been forever and now I hear noises inside the house too. Papa, please come home and make the noises go away. I don't care about Burwich anymore. Just please come home, Papa.
Well, it doesn't sound like any of that was related to monsters. It just sounds like a combination of domestic and child abuse and abandonment.
Yeah, so, the mother locked the kid in the room.
Because yeah, nothing for us to get involved with here. Sorry, we only deal with, like...
Monsters and goblins.
I was going to say monsters, but then I was thinking, well, child abuse, that's kind of, like, monstrous. So I should clarify, we only deal with fantasy monsters.
Yeah, if it's really child abuse, we're not getting involved. Now, if it was pretend child abuse, then that could be something we could look into. Bodies.
I really hope you're not implying fantasy child abuse.
No, really not.
This area is surprisingly quiet.
Yeah, I could hear some grunting, but that could have been your raven.
Yeah, my raven grunts all the time. Oh, more of the road. Look at those dump beholders just spitting lightning.
Shooting the wall. Hey, some scrap. All right, so stairs down just over here.
Yeah.
Let's go have an investigate.
Let's clear out the area first.
Oh, yeah, of course. I've got to remember to use my slam ability.
Yeah, I've got a fireball ability, but it's less fiery than my regular shoot.
Slam can be used with ranged weapons.
Yeah, if I had it on mine, it would probably be crazy. Skill's not ready. I suppose there is one slight advantage to the fireball in that I can do it at the same time as shooting, so I can be like, shoot and fireball slamming.
Yeah. Just like wingtip sparrowhawks.
Yes. I am an XCOM.
You are an XCOM.
Yep. Well, I wanted to speak at the same sort of IQ level as what you just said.
Hodor.
Oh, a way in. Alright, well, before we go in, I think we've probably done enough for this session. We'll just kill these couple of mosquitoes. But join us next time, where we dive headlong into this cave without seeing what dangers await.
See you soon.